We have more Fox and Friends coming up. But you know what? This is a transition for transitions if you've ever had one.
So Fox and Friends.
This is very Fox and Friends. So ready your heart. It's the fifth Sunday of Lent, and our prayer series continues with a reading of prayer from the Hallow app. We all need it. Let's do it this morning. Close your eyes, if you would, bow your head.
There's a lot of attention on TikTok, but an exciting new app is shaking up the marketplace. On Sunday, Fox News introduced prayers to Jesus as part of their broadcast, sponsored by the Bible app Hallow. Let's watch a little bit more.
Jesus, today we begin the holy period of Passiontide. In these last 2 weeks of Lent, help us understand the mystery of your sacrifice and surrender. Make us keenly aware of your love for us. We ask that you make yourself known to us. Help us to feel the grace of your presence. You journeyed to the cross for our sake. May we see ourselves the way you see us and come to believe that we are worthy of your abounding love. In these final days of Lent, help us to follow your holy example. Inspire in us the same sacrificial, selfless love you showed on the cross. Oh Jesus, we surrender ourselves to you. Take care of everything. Thank you again to Hallow for this partnership during Lent.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The network's partnership with Hallow started last month on Ash Wednesday when Fox ran a lengthy segment touting the popularity of Hallow as part of a paid sponsorship. Actors Mark Wahlberg and Jonathan Rumi were part of the segment to discuss the app's Super Bowl ad, which they appeared in, and to push more downloads. They mentioned the company's name a few times, but unless casual viewers knew what to look for, they would never have known this wouldn't have been on the air had the company not ponied up for it. It's a demonstration of how comfortable they are with commodifying and monetizing Christianity in this country, but they take issue with people, and especially Muslims, freely practicing a different religion. You can see here from Jesse Waters, we've had it with Muslims and Arab Americans. But the terms of the Fox sponsorship is unclear, but the in-show banner ads are some of the most valuable advertising real estate on that network, especially on one of its most watched shows. But keep in mind, there is no free version of the app. After creating an account, you get a 30-day free trial before being billed at $69.99 annually to continue praying. Cenk, have you signed up yet? Are you on a prayer regimen?
I love this story because they're literally monetizing Jesus. I mean, how is that for ironic? Why don't they just charge $6.66 per month? I mean, they look like they're the money changers that Jesus threw out of the temple first. I don't know if you guys know this, so if you're a Christian out there, I'm gonna do you a huge service. You ready? The Bible's free. You can open it up and read any prayer you like anytime you want. You don't have to pay $69 a year to somebody to read Bible verses. And by the way, even if you don't want to pick out the Bible verses, go online. There's like a million Bible verses that you'll love. Okay, but this story has a lot more in it than just Fox News and these guys monetizing Christianity. In a sense, they've been doing that from the get-go, right? Like the Fox News guys, the right-wing media, like, oh, we're the best Christians. If you're a good Christian, you come here and then you buy the things that we advertise and you pay more for your cable subscription. Let's go, Christianity, give me the money. Jesus, show me the money. I mean, they're a joke, they're hilarious. But unfortunately, this whole country is taken over by right-wing preachers, media figures, etc. that I don't know if they've never read the Bible or they're just evil, but they say things that aren't the exact opposite of what Jesus said. So, you know, the prosperity preachers who are like, oh, you know, Jesus loved the rich. Are you insane? Jesus said you can't get into that a rich man, that a camel has a better chance of passing through the eye of a needle than a rich man getting into heaven. He said, give away all of your worldly possessions and follow me. Guaranteed that if Jesus was around now, Fox News would call him a communist, okay? And they might actually be right about that. Read the Bible. I didn't say it, Go look up what Jesus actually said. Did he say your prosperity preacher should have a private jet? Did he say Fox News should make billions of dollars monetizing the words that I said to help the poor and the needy? No, he said give away your money. He's 10 times the progressive I am. And so, okay, so that part is clear. But there's something else in here too. TV's starting to run out of money. Look, the entire media industry's got massive problems. So I don't want to say love to see it, but when Fox News is having financial issues, that one's tough not to cheer on. So because in television they never did what is called like these type of live reads, right? This is what they do in radio all the time. Now what people do online, okay? And the TV guys, they were above it. Oh, please, we don't do that type of thing. We get paid $40 million a year and we never have to sell any ads. Now, all of a sudden, you see how awkward they were? Where she was like, this is so Foxed. This is what Fox and Friends would do. And he's like, this is the transition of all transitions. And they're reading ads on air. And of course, they're Fox News, so they bring on Mark Wahlberg and pretend that they were doing a real segment when it's just an ad. And the audience doesn't know it. Oh, so you're having financial issues. Okay, I see you. Interesting. And I'm not a right winger. So even if Mark Wahlberg and I disagree on this, or he's a right winger or whatever, I don't care. He's an awesome actor. I love him. Okay, what do you think, Jordan?
It's just, it's goofy. I was poking around on the website earlier just to see it. And after you select what you would use the app for, where there's different types of prayer or guided meditation, it's like, who do you want to help you with this? And one of the choices was Mark Wahlberg, which I thought was pretty funny, doing this guy with like a Boston accent yelling at you to pick up your prayer speed. I feel like he's just a fitness guy who suddenly also got really into religion. Maybe that's always been the case, that's new to me, but I'm so tempted to sign up. I wish it wasn't that costly, because I kind of want to see what emails they send you when your subscription expires. Do they go into the guilt avenue? Is there any, which I would imagine any other religious organization would do, is there any understanding if you can't afford it but want to continue the services? And I think probably not. It's just, okay, you're out. You can't pray with us anymore. Which really shows that just how disingenuous this is and how far it strays from core tenets of Christianity.
Yeah, I didn't think about the emails. That's a good point, Jordan. I can see them now. Hey, you're out of money. Get the hell out of here, okay? Jesus is only for the rich. Okay, you got that? Okay, if you get, go, oh yeah, go read your free Bible. Okay, hey, to each his own, it's a free country. Well, not quite free. $69.99 if you want to read portions of the Bible. Okay. Yeah, there you go. Hey, are we charging for that? Okay. That's it. Give us another dollar.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.